Once upon a time, in the kingdom of Kropotkin, there lived a young prince.
Being a prince is a drag, man. I mean, I don't want to lead a group. I'll blow comb and tissue paper.
The wicked prime minister hates the prince.
And his rotten music.
But he loves the Princess Amanda from the neighboring kingdom of Calcomania. Naturally, she loves the prince.
But I hate his rotten music too.
You are the greatest comb and tissue paper player of all time, Prince. You ought to lead a group. Go out in the world and lose yourself.
He means I should find myself.
No, I mean lose yourself.
And so the prince went away, leaving the princess to be promised in marriage to the wicked prime minister.
To which I immediately replied,
right, so we made a mistake.
Well, at least we're trying.
It's from the princess.
She wants us to find the prince.
Here, prince. Here, prince.
And bring him back in time to stop her wedding to the wicked prime minister.
I saw that movie.
Here, prince.
The prince?
Yeah, you need a leader for your group.
Terrible. Really bad, huh?
You've got less than 24 hours to get back to Kropotkin and stop the wedding.
Me, I blew great comb and tissue paper.
But you do. You do.
Well, just you say that under the Kropotkin Bell of Truth.
You play beautifully.
Darling.
Prince, are you doing?
Practicing karate. It teaches you how to break a board with your bare hand. Watch. Some karate expert. I should have known it's a bunch of malarkey. Don't you split. Stick around for this important message.
Guys, there's a painter. I'll get some tricks from the kids. Raspberry red. Lemon yellow. Orange, orange.
Hi, kids. Can I have some tricks?
Sure, painter. It's the rabbit, and he ate some tricks.
Silly rabbit. Tricks are for kids.
And sometimes for tricky rabbits.
Now everyone ready for the sing-along? This is the part of the show in which all you people at home join in and sing right along with us. Now this first song starts off with a real bang.
Hold everything, George. Did I just hear you say this song starts off with a bang?
My very words.
Well, if you really expect the people at home to join in, you first ought to put them in the right mood. Yeah?
The right mood?
Certainly. You've got to create the proper atmosphere. Here, I'll show you. Well, what do you think?
I think you flipped your blinking wig.
Well, you said this next song starts with a... bang! Yeah. Are you sure you wouldn't rather do smoke gets in your eyes? Yeah.
Sing, people.
In Penny Lane, there was a farmer showing photographs of every head he's had the pleasure to know, and all the people that come and go stop and say hello.
That was pretty good, but I expect you to do even better on this next number. Just stand right up and shout out the lyrics. Are you ready?
Hold it, George. Ain't you forgetting something?
Forgetting something?
The setting. I keep telling you, you've got to put the audience in the proper mood first.
Well, the last time I listened to your suggestion, we were nearly blown to smithereens.
Sir, no, you're exaggerating. Smithereens is a good 10 miles from here. What you say? Give us one more chance, eh? Hey?
Well, you're all right. This next song is one that really takes off.
Take off, you say? I think I've got just the right thing. Contact! Well, what you think? Yeah?
Let's save it for when we do the Flight of the Bumble Brain. Sing, children.
Eleanor Rigby picks up the rice in the church where a wedding has been. lives in a dream, waits at the window, wearing the face that she keeps in a jar by the door. Who is it for? All the lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? Father Mackenzie, writing the words of a sermon that no one will hear. No one comes near, look at him working, darning his socks in the night when there's nobody there. What does he care? All the lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? Died in the church and was buried along with her name. Nobody came, Father Mackenzie, wiping the dirt from his hands as he walks from the grave. No one was saved, all the lonely people. Where do they all come from? All the lonely people. Where do they all belong?
There, George, your radio's all fixed.
But what's all this stuff on the floor?
Just some leftover parts. You don't really need them. Here's something else that's music to your ears. Yeah. Look, George, a merry-go-round. Come on, let's hop aboard.
Better wait until it stops, Ringo.
Oh, don't be such a...
Ringo, speak to me.
Why in blazes should I? I passed you 12 times and you didn't speak to me.
Stay tuned while our sponsor speaks to you.
And so the good King Arthur rode off with Merlin on further adventures.
John's fallen asleep, John's fallen asleep.
Please don't wake me, don't shake me, I'm only sleeping.
Well, Mr. Percy, let me out. Ah, yes. Oh, it's you, Sir John in disguise, I see, a troubadour. Let's hope we don't have to play that thing.
And so, Your Majesty, this fire-breathing, man-eating monster is smashing drawbridges and laying waste the countryside. Please send us a brave knight to rid us of this curse.
So, who will ride with me upon this quest?
This knightly knight, good King Arthur.
Ah, a troubadour, you would ride with me. Madam, ride you with me and this fair youth. And with Merlin's help...
Merlin's help?
With Merlin's help, peace will come again to your fair land.
Oh, fie. Fiddlesticks and all. Come along now, Terence.
What a mess! Who did that?
He did.
Help! Run for your lives!
Charge!
Arthur is in sore straits. Oh, we will have to put the scourge to sleep.
Yeah, how?
Sing.
Sing? But I'm a group.
A what?
A group, man. Plural. Like I'm four fellas.
Tis passing strange, but anything you say. Right. Double, double. Cause and bubble.
Oh, there you are, John.
Yeah. The fans are getting rougher all the time.
When I wake up early in the morning, lift my head, I'm still yours. Where I am, I'm always
up, John, you're dreaming.
What a dream I had.
We know, we were there. Look at John, I'm flying.
People can't just flap their arms and fly.
They can't. You and your education.
Tune in next week for more high-flying adventures.
In our next adventure, we meet some children.
Cause I'm going to Strawberry Fields.
And had to be rescued by our chauffeur, Jim.
And nothing to get hung about.
John got carried away.
Here are some scenes from our next adventure. It all began with a visit to Scotland Yard.
This show was brought to you by...